Hi, welcome back to the photographycourse.net YouTube channel. In this video, I'd like to talk to you about the circle of confusion. The circle of confusion is a bit of a technical photography term, and it's about how we perceive depth of field in a photo or in a video. The depth of field is also a technical term, and this relates to how much of an image is acceptably sharp, that's acceptably in sharp focus. Whenever you take a photograph, not all of the image is going to be sharp. And how much is sharp depends on a number of factors. The first one that most people think of is the aperture, and this definitely has an effect on the depth of field. How you set your aperture will help determine whether you have a shallow depth of field or a deep depth of field. Setting a wide aperture, that's a low f-stop number, is going to give you a shallower depth of field than if you use a higher f-stop number and a narrower aperture that will give you a deeper depth of field. The focal length of a lens also affects the appearance of depth of field and therefore also implies the circle of confusion and how this relates to the depth of field and how much is acceptably sharp in your picture. A longer lens, a longer focal length, is going to give you an image that appears to have less in focus than using a wide-angle lens will do. So with a wider lens, it's going to look like you've got more in focus than if you used a longer lens. And this, of course, varies depending on the size of your sensor. If you've got a larger sensor or if you've got a smaller sensor, it's going to make a difference in the depth of field and the circle of confusion. Another factor that a lot of photographers tend to overlook when considering depth of field and the circle of confusion is how close the focus point is. So how close is your subject to your camera that you're focusing on? And the effect of this is quite marked. So the closer you get to your subject, the less depth of field there will be. And this then also changes the circle of confusion. If you are close to your subject and really focusing in on it, the circle of confusion is going to appear different than if you're further back. So this is naturally most obvious when you are doing macro photography and are close to your subject. So when you've got a shallow depth of field, the circle of confusion may be less obvious. And photos with a deep depth of field may have no discernible circle of confusion, especially when you set your lens to the hyperfocal distance. Then everything's going to appear to be in sharp focus, but in reality, it's not. So no matter what lens you use, no matter what focal length, no matter how far away you are from your subject or how close to it or what aperture setting you use, there is always going to be a circle of confusion because the only truly sharp part of a photo is where your focal point is. And the circle of confusion happens because of the way light passes through the lens of your camera, which has got a number of different elements inside the lens, and then that light hits the sensor, which is a flat surface. And of course, most of the time, what we photograph is not flat, it's three-dimensional. I hope you found that this video is not too confusing and that it encourages you that there are many aspects of photography that are actually a lot more practical than knowing these things. And you'll find a lot of these things that I teach about in my 365 days of photography course, which covers practical aspects of photography such as exposure and focus and the real important parts of depth of field and capturing your subject in sharp focus and timing and all kinds of other really essential things that are very beneficial to your practical photography experience. I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you have, if you've learned something new, give us a like. If you're new to our channel, click that subscribe button and hit that little bell icon so that you can stay up to date when we release new videos. Thanks for watching.